Lemonade here, and I'm back from vacation, and I really needed that break. But now that I'm back, I'd like to extend my personal thanks to our guest reviewer who covered for me last week. Thank you very much, that really meant a lot to me. But now I'm back, I'm refreshed, and I'm ready to get back to G.I. Joe. So let's review something. Give me something to review. What are we reviewing this week? The Devilfish from 1986. A small vehicle, but I think it's important that we not neglect these small vehicles. I was really glad that the guest reviewer did a review of the Cobra Buzzbore, another small vehicle. I think we need to keep in mind that not every kid could get a USS Flag or a Killer Whale. These small vehicles were more affordable, and a lot more kids could get them. So for a lot of kids, these small vehicles were their G.I. Joe vehicles. And Hasbro made some pretty cool small vehicles. So let's look at one. Let's look at the 1986 G.I. Joe Devilfish.
This is the 1986 G.I. Joe Devilfish. It was first available in 1986 and was also available in 1987. It was discontinued for the year 1988, and there was no new vehicle that replaced it that year, unless you count Tiger Force and Night Force reissue vehicles. The Devilfish did not come with an action figure, but we do have something that I don't normally have with these vehicles. We have the box that the Devilfish originally came in, so we will be able to look at the box for this vehicle. The Devilfish was the successor to the 1984 G.I. Joe Shark Flying Submarine, which was the only small to medium-sized watercraft that G.I. Joe had up until 1986. As you can see, the Shark is a little larger than the Devilfish, and unlike the Devilfish, the Shark came with an action figure, the driver, Deep Six. The closest Cobra counterpart would be the 1986 Cobra Hydro Sled, which, as you can see, is quite a bit smaller than the Devilfish. Or you could send the Devilfish up against the 1985 Cobra Moray, but as you can see, the Cobra Moray is much larger. I think the Devilfish is better matched with the 1984 Cobra Water Moccasin, although the Water Moccasin is still a little bit larger, and it cannot match the Devilfish for speed. I don't think it's quite as much of an armaments mismatch as is the Moray Hydrofoil. The Devilfish appears to be a type of go-fast boat or cigarette boat with its dual outboard engines, but those types of boats usually have a deeper V-shaped hull, but they do tend to have multiple engines for speed. The Devilfish could be a type of riverine craft like the SOCR, which is used for river and close shore insertion and extraction of special forces, but the torpedoes on the bottom suggest that it's designed for combat in the open ocean. It could be a type of torpedo boat or fast attack boat, kind of like the World War II era PT boats, but this really is built more like a sport boat. Let's take a look at the box for the Devilfish, and on the box we have, of course, the great G.I. Joe logo up here and the name Devilfish. We have this really nice box art here that shows a couple of G.I. Joe characters on the boat. We have Beachhead and Wetsuit, and it is firing a missile and its guns and a torpedo all at the same time. But that's meant to look very exciting. Really a very attractive box art. This particular box has the offer for a free Sergeant Slaughter action figure. We have the same artwork on the sides and the bottom, but the top only has the logo. Turning the box around to the back, we see a photograph of the Devilfish here, and it says actual size shown. It floats. We will test that later. The flag points are cut out on this box, but the Devilfish was worth two flag points. The toy photographed on the box is a prototype, and there are some differences between the picture on the box and the toy that came out of the box, most notably the placement of the missiles, which are side by side on the photograph but are offset on the actual toy. The placement of the foot pegs is different, and some other minor details. Let's take a look at the parts and the features of the Devilfish, starting with the guns, and the blueprints for the toy call these guns twin 20mm Mark 12 repeater cannons. These are not based on any real-world weapon that I'm aware of, but they're not intended to be like science fiction laser guns or anything like that, so I can approve. They are fixed and forward-facing. They do not rotate or elevate. Then we have these missiles, which the blueprints call laser-guided Sea Phoenix missiles, and there are four of them. They are all identical, and they fit onto the boat on these pegs, a peg for each of them, and each missile has a slot. They fit on easily enough, and they tend to stay on pretty well. These missiles are pretty simple. They're not very well detailed, and they're probably intended to be a type of anti-ship missile. Anti-ship missiles are usually larger and usually fired from larger vessels or aircraft. On the bow, we have the Devilfish logo, which appears to be a devil that is a merman, and it's kind of strange looking. It has two tails. It has the fish tail and and then it has the devil's pointed tail, and the devil appears to be throwing a lightning bolt spear. I think this logo is kind of cartoonish. I think it looks kind of like an old-style sports team logo.
Looking at the Devilfish logo got me thinking about which G.I. Joe vehicle logo is my favorite, and there are a lot of great ones to choose from. I mean, the Killer Whale had a really cool Orca logo on it. There was the Dragonfly helicopter. The Cobra Water Moccasin had a really cool snake with a machine gun. That looked awesome. I even liked on the Cobra Rattler the Cobra symbol with the wings on it. That was pretty cool. Then, of course, you have the Sky Striker and its eagle logo, which is iconic. And after looking at those, I think the Devilfish logo is really not that great. It's not that it's bad. It's just that normally G.I. Joe logos are so well designed and so awesome looking that a mediocre logo looks poor in comparison.
We have almost a pontoon-like hull where the hull is sort of split down the middle here, and we have two identical torpedoes. The torpedoes are attached on these dumbbell-shaped pegs, and the slot for those pegs go all the way through the torpedo. Now that helps secure the torpedo on the boat, and it keeps the torpedo kind of recessed there inside the hull. The torpedoes are identical and they have stickers, and as you can see, they are bright orange. The blueprints call these wire-guided Mark 78 Captor torpedoes. Wire-guided torpedoes are used to allow the torpedo to get updated targeting information from the ship for a distance after being launched. An example would be the British Tigerfish torpedo. We have a pair of foot pegs, so a couple action figures can ride along the side. And for an example, let's go ahead and use wetsuit, why not? So you can fit wetsuit on the foot peg like that, and he can ride along. With the missiles attached, these outer missiles do crowd the foot peg a little bit, but you can still get the action figure on there. But if you fire this missile, you're gonna give wetsuit a hot foot. Now we get to the driver's seat, and the driver's seat is nicely sculpted, but inside the cockpit, there really is no detail. There's no control panel or control yoke. I'll use Beachhead to demonstrate how to put the figure in the Devilfish. Now there is no back peg in the seat, so you just slide the figure in there until he's seated all the way down in there. It's a little bit narrow, but he sits deep enough down in there that even without the back peg, he's not going to fall out very easily. Now let's look at what makes this boat go. It's dual outboard engines, and these engines can raise up together and lower, and they can also turn in unison thanks to this orange connector that goes between them. Each engine has a removable engine cover. They pop right off. And you can see some engine detail, and I'd have to say that engine detail is kind of minimal. I have seen better engine detail on other vehicles. Between the engines in the back seat, we have these two short, soft plastic black hoses, and these hoses are frequently missing. If they are missing, it's not obvious that there should be something there. And these do not appear to be the same standard hoses that we got with G.I. Joe action figures, like the black hose that came with Dr. Mindbender here. These appear to be thicker. To the left of the driver, we have this fuel port, and not all G.I. Joe vehicles had these, but some of them did, and some G.I. Joe playsets came with fuel pumps, like the 1985 USS Flag, which had this refueling trailer that had fuel nozzles, and you could use this to pretend to refuel your Devilfish. I've been avoiding the elephant in the room, the orange color, which is a problem for some people, and this would be a good color for a rescue boat, but it's absolutely the wrong color for a fast attack craft or a riverine boat. So I would say I agree with the criticisms of the color, but I accept the color just because I'm kind of used to it. It's hard for me to imagine the Devilfish in any other color. I just don't think it would look right, and that's really just because this has become familiar. In the G.I. Joe cartoon, the Devilfish first appeared in Arise Serpentor Arise Part 3, and G.I. Joe is shown to have multiple Devilfish, and just about any Joe could drive it, so it was kind of like the Sky Striker in that respect. In the G.I. Joe comic book, the Devilfish first appeared in issue number 47, an issue with an iconic cover showing Hawk, Beachhead, and Wetsuit riding the Devilfish into battle. In that issue, the Devilfish does go up against the Cobra Hydro Sled, and like the cartoon, G.I. Joe is shown as having more than one Devilfish. It is miscolored in that issue. It is shown as being green, and green would probably be a better color for it, but since I'm used to seeing it in orange, the green somehow doesn't look right. It also has a different shape in the comic book, and the way it looks in the comic book, I think it looks a lot like a Battlestar Galactica Viper. Can it float? Yes, it can float, as it should. After all, the back of the box says it floats, so it does float very well. But will it float when it is loaded with action figures? This is going to be a bigger challenge. I don't know what's going to happen. Let's see. Does it float? It does still float. It's not quite as stable, but it is still floating. One side note, the torpedoes and the missiles also float, so that's a good thing. For kids playing with this in the swimming pool or in some other body of water, they're not going to lose the missiles or the torpedoes.
Looking at the Devilfish overall, it's probably a middle-tier vehicle, but I don't think it's fair to compare the Devilfish to a large, tricked-out vehicle like the Killer Whale or the Sky Striker. Those vehicles were built for size and for features, but the Devilfish, when compared to other small vehicles, fares a bit better. Probably the biggest problem most Joe fans will have is with the color, and I can't disagree. I'm not sure how they came up with this orange color for this vehicle. Maybe they were thinking of it more as a rescue boat, which would make sense, but all the weapons on it make it look more like an attack boat than a rescue boat. But I'm not sure I would change the color, though. After all these years of seeing the Devilfish as an orange boat, I'm just kind of used to that color. I mean, you could recolor it green like a riverine craft, or maybe blue or gray like a PT boat or a torpedo boat, but for me, for better or worse, the Devilfish is an orange boat. But aside from the color, the Devilfish has a lot going for it. It has plenty of missiles and torpedoes, it has guns, it can hold 3 action figures, and those 2 outboard engines look really cool and make it look really fast. A kid playing with this could have it going infinity miles per hour. I did have this vehicle as a kid, and I really enjoyed it. By the time this vehicle came out, a neighborhood friend had the USS flag, so we needed the Devilfish to defend the flag against sea attack. So this vehicle got a lot of use. The biggest missed opportunity with the Devilfish is not with the Devilfish itself, it's with the Cobra counterpart. The Cobra hydrofoil is too big, the Cobra hydro sled is too small, and the Cobra water moccasin is about the right size, but it's underpowered. But with the lower price point for this vehicle, you could get 3 or 4 of them and send all of them up against the Cobra hydrofoil. That'd get them. That was my review of the 1986 G.I. Joe Devilfish. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you like it on YouTube, subscribe on YouTube, like me on Facebook, follow me on Twitter. That's what keeps this channel going. And hey, by next week, I should have a bigger Joe space and a bigger space to shoot these videos. Are you excited? Probably not, but I'm excited. And one more special thanks to our guest reviewer from last week. You kept this channel going while I was away, and you did a fantastic job. Thank you so much. Nobody does it better. Makes me feel sad for the rest. Nobody does it half as good as you. Baby, you're the best.